Hi guys, good evening to you all. So, as the introduction says, my name is Sichita. I run a company called Little Black Book Delhi, which is a mix of a lot of things. It's a website, we do interesting walks, events all over Delhi. Now, I want to tell you guys a little bit about my story and how I am and why I'm standing in front of you and talking to you about things like entrepreneurship. So, when you're born and brought up in the city, you tend to take it for granted. You know, you're used to your friends, you're used to your Khan market and your horse caste village and this, that, and the other. And life somehow becomes really monotonous. It gets very tedious. You feel like you're stuck in a rut. So, I'm born and brought up in Delhi. I did my schooling here. I studied economics at Hindu, after which I managed an absolutely amazing stint with at the Commonwealth Games, the opening closing ceremony, which was followed by again a very enterprising, very fun job at an absolutely huge media company, and I was doing marketing and PR for them. Now, I was in a position where I just felt like I was living the same life over and over again, day after day. It was a 9-to-5 job, paid me really well. I had a chance to hang out with my friends, but it just all got so boring. And I felt myself stagnating and becoming static as a person. And that's when I thought there's got to be something more. You know, there's got to be more than just this mundane routine that I'm living. And that's when I thought, you know what? The problem is not with Delhi as a city. The problem is not with my friends or what I'm doing. The problem is with how I choose to see them. I choose to see them as... To see them. I chose to see them as only a one-dimensional sphere as opposed to things that could have a lot of interesting facets and a lot of interesting dimensions. And that is how the Little Black Book Delhi started. It became a way for me to escape from the mundane routine that I was leading, to meet new and interesting people, and to discover the city that I call home, which is Delhi. Now, I feel with entrepreneurship or, you know, self-proclaimed entrepreneurship, what happens is the biggest challenge that you face is fear. You know, you keep asking yourself all these questions, should I do this, should I not do this, is it a calculated risk, you know, will I ever get a return or not? A point comes when something within you just calls at you and says, you know what, stop thinking. Put your thoughts to a rest. Get up, go out, explore, and see something new. And that's essentially how it began. So I got a blog off Tumblr, and I decided to call it Little Black Book Delhi. Next thing I knew, I'm seated across this gentleman who runs a very successful cafe in Horse Caste Village, and I'm asking him about his story. And he tells me that he's half Indian, half Italian. He waited tables in Milan for 8 years before he decided to come back to Delhi and start his own cafe. And I asked him the very same question, you know, did something hold you back? Were you ever scared about doing this? And he answered me in a very simple way. He said, you know, when you want something, it's as simple as putting out your idea in the universe and letting it take its own direction and letting it take its own role. And just simple words, and the beauty about conversations, the beauty about interviewing people, about meeting new people, about going to new places, is that yes, you do get to know other people, you get to hear other stories, but you also find your own story unfolding. You see sides to yourself that you hadn't really seen before, and that's what makes what I do so beautiful, and that's what possibly drives me to wake up every single day and do this every single day of my life. You know, when you're in school or even in college, as most of you are, we like being defined by stereotypes. You know, when you're in school, you want to be the cool kid, you want to be, you know, the popular one, you want to be the nerd, you want to be the smart one. But as you grow older, you'll see that you cannot be a stereotype. You'll see that you are not just a musician, you're not just a bunch of engineers sitting in a room. There's so much that goes into making you you. And I started seeing that with myself as well. And I feel like when I started to ignore the stereotypes that I was defining myself by, I started seeing more of everyone else who I was meeting. I've had the opportunity to meet some incredibly talented people like Akshar. We featured, you know, Vasundhara from Adil and Vasundhara, who I'm going to be talking to later on Little Black Book Delhi as well. And I've had a chance to see how there's so much that goes into one's being, which I completely ignored earlier. And there's so much that you can see when you break away from the stereotype. There's this book that I read that offers an unparalleled principle which I need my life on today. It says, what you see is all there is. The more you see, the more there is. As you know, time has progressed, I was loving what I was doing. I decided to get a URL and open up this platform to a lot of other people who I knew. So what I did was I asked my acquaintances, random people who I met, to come on board and share their experiences. So Little Back to Delhi grew from being a blog where I was just writing it for the fun of it and just documenting my interactions and my travels. And I opened it out to three more people, one of whom has become a partner on Little Black Book today. And if I tell you where we are at status quo, we featured over 40 writers on Little Black Book Delhi. And the cool thing about this is that none of these people are writers by profession. They are united by one and one thing only, which is we want to share. We want to go out, we want to do something, and we want to tell people about it. And that's what makes this process so endearing. One thing that I realized is that travel, it's a state of mind. You know, I could be in a conversation with you or with you, and I could see what you've seen through what you're telling me. I could go to places that I have never been before and see things that I have never experienced before by virtue of a conversation that I have. And that's what made this so amazing. So what you see is all there is. The more you see, the more there is. I'm often asked, you know, what drives you? Or why did you decide to do this? Or were you prepared to do this? The truth is, when I started, you know, when I was working with that media company and I decided to do this, I didn't know what a blog was. I called my computer engineer friend up in America because I thought he was incredibly smart, and I asked him, what is this thing called blogging? And he said, you know, it's like writing a diary, but you just put it out on the World Wide Web. And it started with something as simple as that. When I decided to purchase a URL, littlebackwithdelhi.com, I didn't know where to get it from. I didn't have the makings of a writer. I wasn't even born a writer. I don't think anyone who's ever written for Little Back to Delhi considers themselves to be a bona fide writer. But what made this amazing was I feel that everything that I have gone through in my life has prepped me and enabled me to do what I'm doing today. And that is one thing that I would, you know, really like for you to take away from this, that everything that you go through in life, whether it's good or bad, beautiful, ugly, whatever it is, it's going to all add up someday. Nothing is ever in vain. From my friends and family, I've learned perseverance, I've learned fidelity, I've learned loyalty. From my job at the Commonwealth Games, which was possibly the most arduous and challenging job any of us have ever encountered, I learned how to smile in the face of hardship. I learned how to talk to people who did not speak the language as the same language as I did. Through my job at this big media company, I learned the importance of process and how it is imperative for you to do things the long way, but the right way. So everything that you go through in your life, you must have the faith that it's all going to lead to something positive someday. So tread on. I'd basically like to conclude this by sharing something very simple with you, which is, sharing something extremely simple with you, which is, so another question that you know, that I find myself asking more often than not is, what is my purpose? What am I trying to achieve through this? And the truth is, the way I look at it now is that I'm never going to know the end of what I'm doing. You know, I'm in this today. I hold some beliefs and values very close to my heart today. But the truth is, like everything, change is the only constant. You're constantly going to be evolving. New people are going to be telling you new things which might want you to embark on a journey that you never had before. So you walk with the belief that change is the only constant. Don't think of everything as a moment. You know, when people talk about what is your defining moment, honestly, I have none. And honestly, I am happy I don't have any. Because you're living a lifetime. You aren't living a moment. So very simply put, I mean, Little Black Book Delhi today is not just a website, it's not just an events company, it's a community of people who share common thought, it's a community of people who share common belief. And more than anything else, it's a coterie of people who don't take themselves too seriously. We just have a lot of fun with what we do, and we really love what we do, which happens to be sharing what we're doing with a lot of other people. Where I am right now might not be where I will be 10 years down the line. You know, the sort of path that I'm following right now, I might choose to do something very different. You know, a little back to Delhi today, something that might be something, you know, a 180 degree turn, a few months or a few years down the line. But what I do know is that any time I ever have a moment of doubt, I will remember the young girl who decided to start her very own blog, and she sat with the hope that she's going to rediscover something new, someone new, and see things like she's never seen it before. So another thing about entrepreneurship, which I have learned, is that it's important for you to stay very true to your roots. As you grow older, and as your company advances, and as what you do advances, you're going to get tremendous opportunities thrown at you, which is something, you know, any one of, whether it's Mr. Roopchand who spoke with us earlier, there are a lot of people who are going to offer you a lot, and they tell you, you know, you should do this, you get good money, you get good fame, you get good opportunity. But it is in these moments of temptation, you need to ask yourself, am I being true to how I started this? Am I being true to the initial vision that I had? And am I being honest with myself? Which is where I feel a connection with you, yourself, whether it's through art, whether it's through music, whether it's through graphics, or whether it's through a conversation. You must find a way to come back to something as pure and simple as that. So to all you guys, you know, make the most of the opportunities that you get. Look at the person to your right, and look at the person to your left. I know that everyone is coming from a place. Everyone has a unique story. And each of your stories is going to take you on a journey that the end to which you do not know right now, and you will never know. But have the faith and the hope that whatever you're doing is going to fulfill a larger purpose. And more than anything else, just enjoy it with all your heart. I think that's that. Thank you so much.